StreamYard is the ultimate solution for live streaming, remote guest interviews, and podcasts. And the best part is that you can do it all for free. In case you didn't know, StreamYard is available on your computer via a web browser. There is currently no app to install. What this means is that you can use StreamYard on your computer, tablet, or smartphone's web browser. I'll have an affiliate link in the description down below to a 14-day free trial of the paid versions of StreamYard. I'll also show on screen the differences between the free and paid versions. Now, I do want to note that on the free version of StreamYard, there is this watermark up here. However, it really isn't that noticeable, and while you're trying out the free version of StreamYard, it'll give you a chance to familiarize yourself with it. I'll also show you how you can remove this watermark using the free trial. After you signed up for StreamYard, you'll see the homepage here. From here, you can create a broadcast by clicking on this blue plus create icon. Or, if you look here, you can also see a look at your past live streams and recordings. As you can see, I've been using it since, well, a while. Now, if you continue on, I want to take a look on the left-hand side where you can see videos. This is just another way that you can see your recordings and even, you know, select them all, delete, which I'm not going to do because I need this, especially this for earlier in this video. We also have our destinations, which is how you're going to add and live stream to different places. As you can see on screen, this is the YouTube channel that you're watching this video on. How meta. You can actually add stuff from Meta in the add destination section. Things such as Facebook, pages, groups or profiles, LinkedIn pages and LinkedIn profiles, YouTube channels like the one you're watching, Twitter, Twitch, Hopin, and then custom RTMP. I could make a whole video on what custom RTMP is, but basically, it allows you to live stream to places that aren't listed here that can support that kind of streaming. Places like Kick, so if you'd like to see that, let me know in the comments down below. The other section is repurpose. The cool thing about repurposing is once you've recorded your live stream, podcast, or guest interview, you can then repurpose them into YouTube Shorts, Instagram Reels, Facebook page Reels, or TikToks, all through StreamYard. You also can just clip them in a more traditional 16:9 way. And as you can see here, the only thing that's supported is a YouTube channel. But as you can see with live streaming and destinations, I've already linked my YouTube channel. When you're creating a broadcast, all you have to do is click on that blue Create Plus button, and you can either create a live stream, recording, or an on-air webinar. Now, live streams and webinars are also recorded. You can either make your live stream, which is what we're gonna do for this video, or just have an in-StreamYard doesn't go live anywhere recording setup. So I'm going to click on live stream now. From here, I can either live stream from the studio or live stream a pre-recorded video. Now I can select the destinations from before, or I can click the add new destination button here, and then I can add one of the many different ways. The cool thing about these destinations when you're live streaming is that on the paid versions of StreamYard, you can live stream to multiple different places at once. However, for this video, I'm just going to keep it simple and broadcast to YouTube. Now, for the title, I can go ahead and have a fully laid out description and title just like you would for a normal YouTube video, but for the sake of this demo, I'm just gonna go ahead and make this private. However, if I want, and I wanna schedule this for later and let my audience know I'm going live and build up the hype, all I have to do is click on the schedule for later, and from here, I can upload a YouTube thumbnail and select a date and time. But because I'm gonna make this private, I think I'm just gonna leave it as it is, and then hit create broadcast. Once your broadcast is created, all you have to do is click on Enter Studio. Once you're in the studio, you can see your webcam and your microphone options. This is a little trippy for me since I'm recording this live, but hopefully you get the gist. Under me, I can mute myself by clicking this icon. But now you can hear me again. Then I can stop the camera, which would show me as this avatar. You can edit this, but for this demo, I don't think it's super important. You can also see that my mic is working with this little green graph showing my microphone. If I click on settings, you can see different camera settings such as the general settings, which shows that I am in full high definition 1080p. However, as it says here, it does say that you can only watch in certain areas in 720p, so just keep that in mind. And on the free version, it is defaulted to 720p at the highest option. So just wanted to call that out there. Camera is where you can see me again on camera. Hello, a little weird to camera-ception here, but if you have multiple cameras, you can set them up here. So I have my Cam Link 4K going into my Panasonic G7. Audio, you can choose your different audio levels and devices here. Speaker lets you know how you can hear it. Now, echo cancellation is interesting, and it says important, do not turn this off unless you have a high quality microphone and are wearing headphones. Now, I'm not wearing headphones, but I do have a high quality mic, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn this off. You also have the option to automatically adjust mic volume. Again, if you don't know or don't have the ability to do this, it might be very worth it for you. The next is virtual backgrounds, which if I want to, I can play around with, but I think I'm just gonna go ahead and stick to what I have. I think I'm pretty happy with this setup. Recording is just that. You can either record locally for each participant, so really useful if you're doing podcasting or you're having a guest interview. Really would recommend that. The next is hotkeys, which lets you set up StreamYard with hotkeys. I actually have my StreamYard set up with a Stream Deck, and I'll make sure to include a link in the description down below if you want to do that too. And of course, the next is guests. This lets you do different things, right? So guests can stream into this destination. So if I wanted someone else for some reason to live stream on my YouTube channel or my pages, this is a way to do that. Now, green room is a little bit newer, but as you can see, I actually need to upgrade to a growth or business plan myself. So for this demo, I'm just gonna get out of here. And then we can see my display name. As it is, it's Andrew Can, so I don't need anything more than that. Let's go ahead and enter the studio. In the studio, you're gonna notice my background, but I'm not on stream yet. The way to fix this is in the bottom left-hand corner. It says I am not a part of the stream yet. However, if I want, I can hover here to add myself to the stream. Again, a little trippy to see myself, so what I might do just for myself is go over here, click stop cam. You can see my audio going, but if I need to mute myself, I can do so like I did here on the mute button, or I can do so here as well. Mute my mic. So just a couple of options there. If I need to change anything, I can do this here. So really cool options for you. And I think I'll turn it back on. Here you'll have settings again. So if I click on settings, you'll see these familiar settings. If I go ahead and click the one to the right of it to present. Now I can present my screen, I can present slides, or I can do an extra camera. So if I have another camera going, which I don't right now, but for the sake of this example, you can see that I have two cameras on screen. You also get to look at the different layouts that StreamYard offers. So this is the standard solo layout. It's just me talking directly to you. But if I had a guest, this is how it would look. I'm on the left, the guest can be on the right. If I have the want to have my background as well, you can see the background here. I can also have multiple guests. So this is called the spotlight layout where I'm in center focus. But the cool thing is I can drag and drop my guest and switch them. And I can do that for all. So if I want to be on the left, I can drag and drop while live and it'll switch in real time. Gives you just a way and a little bit more customization. So as we click through the different ways, I could have it where there's picture in picture. So if I'm sharing my screen and I want us in the bottom left-hand corner, that is an option. There's also the camera layout like this. Now, one thing I want to mention is StreamYard recently added the ability to customize your own layout. So if I click on this plus icon right here, so now I can add my own layouts, and in the bottom left-hand corner, I can click on add item. This lets me add a dynamic camera grid, which it recommends, and I can change this in a multitude of ways. I can have it to go to fit, I can have it go to fill, oriented to the bottom. So there's a lot I can change. I can even show 10 different layouts to really get an idea of how this would look. And I really like this because if I have, let's say, 10 guests, which I get in the free trial, I can see what it would look like if I make them like this. Maybe we all want to watch something together in the stream. I can make sure that we have enough room. And then I could add something over here and it really gives you a lot of customization. I can build graphics around this and I could save this if I want. 10 guest layout, which is one of the cool features of StreamYard. Another cool thing you can do in StreamYard is pull comments from the different places you're streaming to. If I click on this show, as you can see, the comment will show up no matter where you're streaming to, if you're live, and that's really cool. Another thing you can do is with banners, have different style banners. So if I want like a ticker tape style banner recommending you to join our Discord server, which I'll have a link in the description down below, this is what that looks like. But I can also have static banners on screen, something like this, which says paid. So maybe I want to show that this is a paid feature or a free feature. You can actually have both, which I think is really cool. The next section is brand. And brand is where you can set and build your own brand. I have one set up for the Can Do Creator community, also our Discord server, which I mentioned earlier. A little funny how that works, huh? You can choose your own brand color, and this is based on a couple of ways you can do it. You can select here or enter in your hex code. I've entered in ours there. You can choose to display your name or even headlines, which is a cool feature. So let's say I wanted to say YouTuber and add that with what I am. So in case someone is joining for the first time, they get an idea that I'm Andrew Camp. I'm a YouTuber, and this is really useful if you're doing a live guest interview or a podcast. You can just turn them off here though, which I'm gonna do. I mentioned earlier, if you have the free versions of StreamYard, you will have this watermark. Now, as simply as I added it here, all you have to do to remove it with the free trial is click it again and it's gone. Like I said, it's really not that noticeable and it gives you a cute image of Puddles the Duck. Now, the next thing you can have is overlays. Again, I keep mentioning the Discord, I'm sorry about that, but this is just the overlays I have here. You can also use the StreamYard overlay like this, which it says Live with StreamYard, StreamYard Live Show, and you can add your own. If you ever need to know the dimensions or anything, StreamYard does a really good job with these tooltips to give you the dimensions here, so shoutouts to StreamYard for making it easy. You can also load video clips, which is cool, so let's say that you have a video you want to show off, this lets you do it. If you want to have a countdown timer that you can edit out in YouTube after, it's that simple. And then this is how I have my background set. So if I go back to the two camera view where you can see the background, you can see I have some different layouts of my background. And another cool feature that you have in StreamYard is the ability to add background music to your live streams. You can loop that music so it keeps playing, so you can use some of these default ones they give you, or you can add your own music. I'd recommend Epidemic Sound for your music, but there's also things that are free like Nick Nimmin's Creator Mix, and I'll have links to both of those in the description down below. Finally is the private chat. So this is if you need to chat with people and it doesn't need your audience to see. This is very useful if you're going live and you have a moderation team and they're like, hey, someone keeps asking this question, or hey, you need to raise your mic levels. Not necessarily important for your audience to see, but super important for you and the person going live to see. And then once you're ready to go live, if you don't need to make any edits to what you're doing, all you have to do is click this blue go live button. Now, I'm not going to be clicking it just yet because I'm not live streaming this. However, you can see that you can still locally record. So let's say you also want to record and save this to your StreamYard account. You can click on this and record locally for each participant. So if you want to edit it later, you have the full ability too. That's some of the amazing things you can do with StreamYard. You can go live, record you and a guest, and of course, have a lot of fun. Now, if you'd want to learn how to make a live stream thumbnail, check out that video on screen. Remember, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can use StreamYard to live stream and record content, then you can too.